Welcome back to Shop Talk's Food Guide for 2012. Still with us is Nana Ozaeta, editor-in-chief of Food Magazine. Okay, Nana, we talked about the trends. Let's talk about actually being in the business. And a huge part of being in the food business now is being able to have that online social media presence. What's the secret to making social media work for you?
Well, first of all, it's great that there's this tool for restaurateurs to use. Because these days, if you're successful and you get the word out quite fast, you can get your return on investment in a matter of months. Whereas in the old days, it would take a year minimum for you to get your money back when you set up your restaurant. But now, you get the buzz out much faster. It's not just word of mouth, as in someone telling someone, but it's putting yourself on Facebook and having all these likes and all these friends coming on. So definitely the number one is to be on Facebook, to be on Twitter, to have a website. You can even invite bloggers to come and sample your food, and getting the word out is right away, and it's just being very conscious and very deliberate about that. Not as an afterthought, but say, okay, this is how we're going to do work on our Facebook page. This is how we're going to get likes. This is how we're going to spread the word through Facebook, for example.
Right. So people are spending less money on marketing in that sense, because obviously Facebook and Twitter and that are free. But the problem with that I see is everyone is on Facebook. Every business, whether you're big or small, is already on Facebook or Twitter. So in that mix, how do you make yourself stand out?
Well, first of all, again, it's just getting people in the door. Okay, that's all you need to do through that phase. You just say, come and visit a restaurant. And Filipinos, and especially Filipinos here in Manila, we just love to try out new restaurants.
That's so true.
So as long as you can somehow get the word out that, hey, just come in. And then once they come in, then it's a whole other ballgame. Now you have to impress them with your food. And that's a whole other thing altogether. So it really shouldn't be too hard. As long as you're not offering what you put out there in Facebook, it's intriguing enough. Like you're opening a ramen shop, for example. A little while, some time ago, I visited No Mama, a new artisanal ramen. Owned by Chef Himoy de Baron. It's a wonderful place, and you just post something about the wonderful ramen that he has there, and right away people will go. And when they come in, they're not going to be disappointed.
Right. I mean, I've talked to people who have restaurants and food businesses, and when it comes to bloggers, you will either love them or hate them, because they can make you or destroy you, right?
Actually, that really is the reality. When you put yourself out there, and I'm not just talking about bloggers, I'm just talking about people in your friends in Facebook, or your Facebook friends, or your Twitter followers. When you put yourself out there, you're also open to every single negative comment that can come your way. And unfortunately, when you're new, you're still in soft opening. And what the soft opening mean is your staff are not fully trained yet. You're still trying to source better suppliers for your ingredients, etc. So you're very vulnerable. You're at your most vulnerable. And that's the time when people are coming to your restaurant, and the moment they eat your food, they don't even have to go home and log into their computer from their mobile phones. They can say, oy, don't try this place, ang pangit ng pagkain dito. So, or, that there was a case of food poisoning or something, and that gets spread out. No, and that's really the danger. So what I like to think is that there's no such thing as a soft opening anymore. The moment you open to paying customers, you really have to be very vigilant, because any single thing can happen, and that will be posted online.
Right.
Whether it's for whether it's a blogger, whether it's just someone coming in with a Facebook account and lots of friends on Facebook.
Right. Okay, having said that, if, there was an unfortunate incident in your business, somebody was not pleased with the product or with the service, and, put it out into cyberspace, and now the whole world's read it. How do you recover from that?
Well, I think that's where the media blitz is really important, and that could be just. It depends on the gravity. If it's like someone just saying, "Oh, I didn't like the barbecue here," then that's no big deal. We all have our own preferences, and that can be, as long as you stay visible online, that can be remedied. Now, of course, if it's something like food poisoning or like really bad service, then a media blitz is very important, and hiring a consultant to help you map out a strategy would have to be the next step.
So you would have to bring in the big guns for
damage. Most likely, because really it could be something small and you could ignore it. But the thing with the web is that it stays there forever. And anyone doing a Google search, oh, I want to try this restaurant, let's Google it, and that story will be there.
They can dig it up from years ago.
Yes, that story will be there. So it's important to come up with more fresh news about your restaurant that would supersede whatever negative publicity you had prior.
Right.
And also, it also means just also taking care of your loyal customers.
Okay. True.
Don't worry too much about the people you don't know or the one-time visitors. But keep your, you really should never forget the people who come in
regularly
and take care of them, because they're in, at the end of the day, I know it sounds old-fashioned, but they're still your best advertisement, because they're the ones coming in and they're the ones bringing their friends and their family.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So in the long run, those loyal customers are very important.
Yeah. Love the regulars.
Yes.
Okay. What are the other challenges that food entrepreneurs will face this year? Obviously, the economy is always an issue. I don't know when we're going to be able to say, hey, the economy is great. But, you know, apparently it's really not where it could be or should be. So what does that mean?
Well, you know, you're right. Every year it's always an issue of economics, no? And it's always, customers are always trying to save money. Okay, they don't want to spend. So they have, let's say, $500. Will they use it for a cell phone load? Will they buy a gadget? Or will they go and frequent your restaurant? Well, for me, it's really not about, oh, you have to have cheap meals. It's about value for money, and that's a rule that I've talked about quite often. As long as you are giving your customers or helping them see that they're getting their money's worth, they'll be more than happy. And especially for those who really enjoy eating, you know, you're going to spend that money on a really good meal rather than buy a new blouse or a new bag, no? And as long as they feel that they're getting what their money's worth, then that's the way to go. Because some restaurants cannot, you know, they're not going to bring their prices down to like 50 pesos for a meal, you know? I mean, that's not their market. So, but it's a matter of, you know, giving extra service, giving freebies, like whenever you order an entree, you get a free drink or a free side dish, or if you come back, you get a discount coupon, so if you come back, you can get a discount. Those are the little touches that will make your customer feel appreciated and say, wow, so lit, or else servings are big, don't scrimp on the servings, even if you have to charge a little extra. People like that.
Yeah, you go to a restaurant, and then, you know, the servings are this big, you go back a couple of months or a year later, it's the same thing. Tastes the same, but it's like
it's small,
that
yes.
at the same price.
Right. Yeah. Right. There's nothing like big servings to make people say, "Okay, I'm paying my, I'm getting my money's worth."
Right, yeah. Right.
So again, it's just that whether it's real or not, you're getting value for your money, and it can be done through service, through servings, through freebies or little extra little touches, and they can be small touches, you know, that would make customers feel like, okay, my money was well spent.
Right. Okay, well, this is the current issue of Food Magazine. This is your December-January issue, and I understand these are in short supply. They've been flying off the shelves, so it might actually be difficult to get one. However, what is in this issue that people really must read?
Well, this is our holiday issue, and so I know it's past Christmas, but there are like a lot of wonderful things in there. For one thing, on our cover, we tried to, it's a plain old macaroni salad, but what we did was let's make it a spectacular macaroni salad.
It looks amazing.
As we can make it. And so we did sort of a layered style, like a trifle, and you've got sun-dried tomatoes, you've got macaroni, of course, you've got arugula, we've even got smoked salmon, we've even got lobster, and, you know, you mix that all up with a mayo dressing, and, you know, it's really lovely, not just for Noche Buena, for any time of the year.
Yeah, and I'd like to say it's not as sinful as the other stuff on your Noche Buena
exactly,
table.
Exactly,
right?
Yes. So what's nice about this issue is that we tried to come up with something that's so simple and so everyday, and we just said, hey, present it a different way, and you're going to get, your guests or your family is going to be really pleased.
Right, make it something really, really
We also
special.
Have we also do our usual Presents Perfect holiday guide, and there are some wonderful pastries, food items that you can look into, and which are really good all year round. You can order them all year round for birthdays or other events.
There
are a lot of great finds in that issue.
A lot of special occasions coming up. So this is the December-January issue of Food Magazine. Nana Ozaeta, thank you so much for coming on Shop Talk today.
Thank you so much. I enjoyed it.
All right. Well, thank you guys for watching Shop Talk. I'm Ria Tanwat-Cotrillo. Please follow ANC Shop Talk on Twitter and be a fan of ANC Shop Talk on Facebook. Enjoy the rest of your day.